Jubilant Organisys has announced restructuring. We're going across to the management. Mr. R. Sankaraya is Executive Director of Finance at the company. Sir, thanks for being with us here on the show. First off, can you explain to us in very simple terms what have you done? What is the demerger all about? The divisions that you're moving out of the company into a new company, which are the divisions which are being moved together, you know, in the merger process?
Thank you, Prashant. Basically, we are getting into a scheme of arrangement which has a merger of two small entities. One is called Specialty Molecules, which is a 100% wholly owned subsidiary of Jubilant Organisys, which has been acquired by Jubilant in 2008. Basically, it is in pyridine derivative products, which is one of our core products. So that company is getting merged with Jubilant Organisys. Along with that, there is a converter who is converting our consumer products business. That converter is also getting merged with Jubilant Organisys. So merger of SML, that is Specialty Molecules, there is a merger of PMSL, that is Space Marketing Specialty Limited. These two companies are getting merged with Jubilant Organisys. And to create a focused entity in Jubilant Organisys as a pharmaceuticals and life science products and services, we are demerging the entire Agri Products and Performance Polymer division into a separate company which will be called as Jubilant Industries. So in the process, the demerged company and also the existing company will be continued to list in BSE and NSE. The demerged company, which is the specialty, which is the Jubilant Industries Limited, that also will get listed in BSE and NSE, and the shareholders of every 20 shares held by Jubilant Organisys will get one share of 10 paid up capital in Jubilant Industries. Ultimately, if you see, a mirror image shareholding will be reflected in Jubilant Organisys and Jubilant Industries. That is the entire scheme.
Okay, that's pretty clear. So the demerged entity will be the Agri and Performance Polymer business of the company, and that will be called Jubilant Industries, the name of Jubilant Organisys after the merger of these two entities, these two subsidiaries into itself, will also be changed to Jubilant Life Sciences Limited, right?
Absolutely right, because basically Jubilant Organisys subsequently will be focusing only in pharmaceuticals, life science products and business. So that will be renamed as Jubilant Life Sciences. The new company will be called as Jubilant Industries because it will consist of fertilizer business, it will consist of our performance polymer business.
The agri and performance polymer business contributes what, 10-11% of your revenues right now?
Yeah, approximately, you're right.
And the other two entities which you will merge with Jubilant Organisys, can you talk about that? What, you know, what's the performance of these two entities? Were these being already consolidated in the earnings of Jubilant Organisys?
Yes, the Specialty Molecules, which is being 100% subsidiary of Jubilant Organisys, the results of Jubilant Organisys is already consolidated. It is a simple merger process, thereby the existing investment and the share capital will get cancelled. There is no fresh issue of share capital which will happen. Whereas the converter, the contract manufacturer of our consumer products business, that will get also getting merged. And in that case, instead of cash payment, we are going to issue fresh shares, which has been on a fair market basis, valued by PwC and the fairness opinion given by Kotak Mahindra Capital Limited. So that will have as of today, if you see the entity which is getting merged as a converter, we have a sale of about 80 crores approximately last year, FY 2010. The sale which is accounted in Jubilant Organisys on account of conversion of the products by PMSL.
Okay, all right, fair enough. You know, because of this demerger, is there any impact on business agreements or, you know, any sort of arrangements you probably might have entered with, you know, with companies? Because this is in consumer products business, you know, food polymers, application polymers, all of this is in the demerged entity. Will it have any impact whatsoever?
No, in fact, it will have a very positive impact. The advantages will be, as of today, if you see, Jubilant is mainly focusing in pharma and life science products and services. So, I may not say that the other business is neglected, but the adequate focus on the performance polymers business and fertilizer is not given today. But by creating a separate independent entity, we will have two separate boards which will be running these two companies independently, and their investment decision will be taken based on the economics of that particular product and relationship with the particular customer. Otherwise, what is happening today is the focus is being more of pharmaceuticals. So all the investments are going into Jubilant in pharma and life science. So, but now, since there is a, if you see, for example, in Jubilant Industries Limited, the agri business, which is a single superphosphate, which we are one of the largest in India, there is no adequate focus being given as of today. That will be created a new focus entity. We will give a better advantage to expand the growth plans in fertilizer business. Also, if you see the product like solid PVA, which is a chewing gum base, there as of today, we are the third largest in the world. We have huge opportunities in India and also outside India to expand this further. As of today, the greater focus is not given. So by creating a separate entity, we will be in a position to better create a better focus on the new entity. And also, if you see the vinylpyridine latex, which is again, we have a huge opportunities globally available. We are again third largest in the world, which we have very clear-cut plans to grow this business and move up to the level from third to maybe next level position. So those, by creating this focused entity, we will be in a position to create more synergies in a separate independent entities, and also the grow the businesses in a very, very focused manner with the independent board being created.
This does not impact the CRAMS business at all, does it? Knowing the CRAMS business.
Absolutely there is no impact on CRAMS business. In fact, like I mentioned, the focus on CRAMS will strengthen now.
By when do you get to plan to get this new entity listed? By when will that happen?
See, as of today, if you see, our plan is we will file it with the stock exchange, and subsequently we'll file it with the court. After court approvals, we will be in a position to list. The indicative time target for getting the court approval is in the month of December.
Okay, all right, fair enough. We'll leave it at that, sir. Good luck with the restructuring. Thanks for taking out the time and talking to us on this one.